Namaste. In this video, we are going to learn how to conduct a quiz examination using Google Form. So, in order to do that, say new, more, Google Forms. We know how to prepare a Google Form and how to rename this Google Form and add questions. Let us take a form where we have prepared questions and we have given name to this particular form and few instructions are added. We know that this form is collecting automatically email addresses. We'll see how to set up this, followed by name of the user and maybe division, year and so on we can add. Here we have added only collecting email addresses and full name of the user, and then we have added questions. Let us try to understand how to make these questions as a quiz and assign marks to each question and the correct answer. In order to do that, go to settings. And there are three options: general, presentation, quizzes. Under general, collect email addresses by checking this. Also give receipt response to all users by checking this, which will help user to know in later on that what answers he has submitted. Restricted, it all depends on whether you want to give response received to users or not. Then only users who are from this particular domain can attempt the quiz. Then we check this. Always limit to one response so that one user should not attempt more than once a particular quiz. And also do not check this so that user cannot modify a particular answer later on once he or she submits the quiz. Under presentation, as we know, one important option that we have is we can shuffle the questions answer order, which will be received by different users as a different order. So check this. Under quizzes, if you want this form to act like a quiz and assign a correct answer and point value to each question, then check this. Of course, we are making quiz and we have to check this. There is another option called log mode on Chromebook. If users are having Chromebook, then we can check this on, where users cannot use any other tab or browser to search the answers. The next option is do not release immediately after the submission the grades. Otherwise, students will be able to see the informations. So always release the grade after manual review, as the case here. Also, do not check this particular option, otherwise students will be able to see the answers. Check this missed questions, which user once submits will be able to know which are the questions he missed. And also check this so that user note what are the points assigned to each question. Once this is done, then say save. So in the form we have one question, set of questions. Second option is responses. So once these questions are added, then we should also know in the question that how to select a correct answer and assign a point value to each question. To do that, click answer key, and then as you see the true answer is correct, so this is checked. So that means this answer is correct. Once this is selected, then user should get 1 point. You can also change this, but right now we are keeping as 1 point, and then say done. There is another option called required. If this is not checked, then user can submit form without answering this question. But if it is checked, then user cannot submit unless he or she attempts this particular question. Okay, this is how we assign point value to each question and the correct answer, as you can see here. Okay, so now next is responses. Once this is done, then we can send this particular form and start receiving responses by going here. Say send, and always best option is use a particular link and shorten this, and always mail this particular link to all the users through mails instead of adding email here and sending the form. So once this is blue, and then if user gets the link of this particular form, he or she will be able to attempt the quiz. But if it is red, then all the users who are in the process of attempting quiz will not be able to submit their form and will not be able to receive their responses. So this has to be done carefully. There are at least two ways which we can think of. One is manual switch on and switch off. Second is using add-on. So in order to use add-on, we can say install add-on. We have already installed add-ons. There are various add-ons like Timeify or form limiter. I'll be using form limiter to show how to set this. So set limit. So we'll get a particular window where we can set date and time. So from this option, we will select set time and date. Select date, let's say 1st May, and then set time. Let's say we want to conduct quiz between 2 to 3 p.m. So I say 2 p.m. it should 2 to 3, then we should say 3 p.m. it should stop accepting responses. So 3 p.m. so quiz is 2 to 3, and 3 p.m. it should stop taking the responses. This is what we set, and then we say that this particular form, once closed, this particular message will be sent to all the users, and then save and enable. So as you can see, if you save and enable, this particular quiz is now on, and it will stop accepting responses at 3 p.m. on 1st June. Okay. So one thing we should keep in mind, that the best option could be switch off this or stop accepting answers and send this particular form in advance. Let's say the quiz is 2 to 3. We can send this particular form by doing this 10 minutes in advance, so that all users get this form. And we can ensure that they have this form has been sent, and all users can read the instructions carefully, and they'll be ready to attempt the questions. Once it is 3 p.m., we can say manually switch on. That is, start accepting the responses. And remember, as we have set this limit, this form will be automatically stop accepting responses as 3 p.m. or another option is, we can also manually stop accepting responses, maybe at 3 p.m. or 3 after 2-3 minutes, maybe 3-2 and so on. So that's the option. Once the responses have received, the quiz is over and the responses have received, let's say responses, we get something like this. There are many users who have given responses at different times and they have got this score. Okay. Now this is in not particular order, this is random. There are 60 students or 120 students in a class, let's say, and these students have submitted their form as and when they have got all the answers and submitted. But you have to prepare the mark sheet, and we know that in our class, the students are in this particular order and with roll number and email ID. So we can fetch this particular responses in a sorted order, something like this. So this is already there with you, and we have just added one column here. We can fetch this particular answer from the response sheet by matching this particular email address. The formula you can see here, this is the formula which you can use to do so. Okay, this hash NA shows that this particular user did not attempt the quiz or failed to submit the form. So as you can see the statistics here, 125 students passed, 0 students failed, and total 21 students were absent. Maybe they were not able to submit the quiz, or they did not get the quiz, and so on. Total 146 students were there in a particular division or two divisions. So I hope this video is useful. That's all in this video. And finally, I would like to mention that always prepare a list of email addresses to whom we are going to send this form. As you see, we have prepared a list of email addresses. Rather than sending the quiz to a group email ID, and always send the quiz well in advance, maybe 10 minutes in advance, so that users can read the instructions and attempt the quiz. But when we are sending the quiz in advance, make sure that you do not accept responses. Let them read the instructions, and once it is let's say quiz is 2 to 3, once it is 2 p.m. then switch this on, and then say accepting responses and users can start attempting the quiz. Once it is 3 p.m. you can stop this particular responses. Remember that once you stop this, all the users who are in the process of attempting, they will not be able to submit the quiz. I hope this particular video is useful for all the users. That's all in this video. Thank you.